In this video, and we are having 7 practicals, and in today's class I will try to cover as much practicals as possible in this video. Otherwise we will make the second part in which I'm going to cover the rest of the practicals, right? So let me copy first 3 practicals to my IDE, right? So let me copy it here. So the first practical is write a program to check whether the given string is palindrome or not, right? So before trying to understand the program, let me explain the logic over here, that what exactly the palindrome is. You know, someone is having say name Anna. So here, if I read string from this direction or this direction, both of the pronunciation is similar. That means if string and its reverse string both are having equal value, right? So that means those strings are called as palindrome. So palindrome strings are, say if I am writing P, Q, R, R, Q, P, then this is called palindrome, because even if I read it from start to end or end to start, it will be similar. So can I say that if string and its reverse or reverse of the strings are equal, then that string is called as palindrome, right? So this is the definition for the palindrome of a string. So now let me write a program for that. So for that, I am opening my IDE, and inside this IDE, let me first add include stdio.h, then int main, then here return 0. After that, I have to take string.h as well, because I can perform this program with using inbuilt function and without using inbuilt functions as well. So I am writing it with string functions. So first I am taking two strings, s1 having 100 and s2 having 100. Now I have to take these strings from user, so that's why I am writing printf. Or I don't want this second string, right? Because I just need to check. So I am telling user enter any string to check. Now how can user enter get this? So here it will be s1. Now let me save this program first, strings. Now how can I, you know, do this? So what I am doing, I am taking another string, say rev, right? I am naming it as rev. So what I am going to do, first I am going to copy whatever string entered by user, I am going to copy that same string to rev. How can I copy? I cannot use assignment operator, so that's why I can use strcmp that is compare now strcpy function to copy one string to another, and it will be copied from RHS to LHS. That's why I have to write, right? So now the value of S1 will be copied to REV string. Now REV and S1 both are having same string. Now I am going to do strrev of the string REV. So I am going to reverse the string, right? So what you what I have done, if I just tell you the logic over here, what I have done, first I am taking string from user. So first, suppose user is entering say Komal, so S1 will have this value and REV is having some kind of garbage value, right? Now I am doing strcpy of S1 and REV. So what will be done? Value from S1 will be copied to REV. So now after this statement, REV is also equal to Komal and S1 is already Komal. Now both of the strings are similar. Now if I perform strrev over REV string, then what is happening? It will reverse the string, that is LAMOK. So now and again store it back to REV. So my new REV become this. Now how can I check whether it is palindrome or not? If I compare both of the string REV and S1, now if it gives zero, that means those strings are similar, so I can say the string is palindrome, otherwise string is not palindrome, right? So I hope you guys are understanding the logic. So here what I am doing at this moment, I am having S1 as well as its reverse. So now I am using strcmp comparison, and here I am taking x. So I have to declare x as integer variable. So here int x, right? Now here I am comparing S1 and REV. So if the value of x, if x equal to 0, that means printf given string is palindrome, right? And let me copy this statement, and here else part, let me paste it, is not palindrome. Let me save this program and check if our assumption of this program is correct or not. So I am entering Komal, so the given string is not palindrome. Okay, now if I just compile it and I am entering PQRRQP, so the given string is palindrome. So this is how we will perform this program. So we are done with the first practical. Now the second practical is write a C program to reverse the input string. Now in the further practical, you are going to see that we are going to perform this program even without using default function strrev. So if you want to reverse the string, you can use strrev, but we can also perform this program even without using it. And that practical is going to be performed in this practical list also. So I am going to eliminate this thinking that we are going to use strrev, and that we have already performed in the string functions video. So I am not going to repeat it. Now the third practical is write a C program to count the number of words in a given string. So what exactly they want? So if I understand the logic, what they are telling me, they are giving me one string saying today is a good day. Now suppose user have entered a string like this, they want us to find number of words. So the answer should be printed for this statement is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So number of words in this statement is 5, so 5 should be printed. So they want this. How I what you know, what logic should be applied in order to get this answer? I hope you guys can understand that here each word is separated using a space. So if I count this space, then the number of words equal to space plus one. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces are there. So number of words equal to number of spaces plus one, that is 5. My answer. You can, you know, you can apply this logic by taking any example. You can see if this logic is correct or not. So I can imagine that that it is entire one array, and here I have written today space is space a space good space day. Please pardon my handwriting over here or representation. So today is a great day. So here it will be having index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. And I am giving it name str. So I will check str of I where I ranges from 0 to 18. And I will check if str is equal to space or not. If it is space, I will do space equal to space plus 1, right? So this will be the logic for this video. So let me just erase this and go to my IDE. So now I am having one string S1 for which I am going to find the space. Here instead of X I am writing words, right? So words over here, or you can also use space. Okay, you can take any name. So enter any string to check. Okay, then S1 will be entered. Now I don't need this, so I am just erasing this extra code. Now what can I do? I am taking a look for I equal to 0. Now you can go up to length, or you can go up to you encounter null, that we have already performed in the basic level of program. So I am not going to explain it right now, but you can starting with 0 and then you will check if S1 of I is not equal to null, then do I plus plus. So it will go until the last character. Now what I am going to check? I am checking if S1 of I is equal to, if S1 of I is equal to space, then I am going to do space plus plus, or you can do space equal to space plus 1. So at the end of this loop I will get number of spaces, right? So now printf number of words in given string is percentage d, and here either I can take another variable words equal to space plus 1, or you can directly write space 1 over there, but I am taking the words, right? Is it correct? Words, yes, correct. So here it will be words, and let me just semicolon it, save it, compile it, and let me check if it is correct or not. So what are they saying? Okay, I have done comma here instead of semicolon. So let me do semicolon, save the program, compile it and run it. It is, you know, not giving me any error. So today is a good day. So number of words in a string is 5. You can check it for any words. You can check it for if the program logic is correct or not. So this is how you can perform a program in which I can find the number of words in a given string. Okay, so now let me so this is all about today's class. In the next video I am going to talk about the rest of the practicals, so stay tuned with me. If you have any doubt, you can comment below the comment section and ask me. Thank you so much. See you in the next class.